In my previous videos, I have explained the principle of IR spectroscopy and types of vibrations in IR spectroscopy and as well as Hooke's law in IR spectroscopy. In this video, I am going to discuss about single beam and double beam IR spectrophotometer. Let's say here I am going to explain the working principle of single beam and double beam IR spectrophotometer. Let's see one by one. Okay, here this is a single beam IR spectrophotometer. This is the instrumentation. You see, first what are the instrumental parts? Radiation source, sample cell, entrance slit, mirror, then prism, then rotating litho mirror, then exit slit, then detector. I will explain the working principle of this single beam IR spectrophotometer, how it will work. You can see, first from the radiation source, the light from the radiation source will fall onto the sample cell. The radiation from radiation source will fall onto the sample cell. After falling on, the sample absorbs some amount of radiation. The sample absorbs some amount of radiation and remaining transfer through it. And remaining will fall onto the mirror by passing through entrance slit. Remaining fall onto the mirror by passing through entrance slit. The purpose of entrance slit is to get the narrow radiation only. Whenever the transmitted radiation on falling on mirror, the nature of mirror is reflecting only. Here the transmitted radiation on mirror will reflect towards prism, then towards rotating litho mirror. From the mirror, radiation will be reflected. Radiation reflect towards prism and rotating litho mirror. Here, both these two means rotating litho mirror and prism. Both these two useful for the selection of desirable wavelength. Whatever wavelength we want. That can be selected by using rotating litho mirror and as well as prism. From this, after falling on this mirror. Then again, its nature is reflecting. It again, the radiation falling on mirror, we can see here, it again reflects back. Reflect back to the mirror. From the rotating mirror and prism, and it is reflected back to the mirror. Then from this mirror, it is going to fall on detector by passing through exit slit. Fall on the detector. Here, whatever the desired wavelength only, that can only pass through the exit slit. The remaining will be stopped by exit slit. Here the detector will detect the intensity of transmitted radiation in the function of wavelength. This is the single beam IR spectrophotometer. Same method I have given here. Radiation from light source is allowed to fall on sample cell. Then sample absorbs some amount of radiation and remaining transmitted through it, mirror by passing entrance slit. Then after falling on mirror, what will happen? Then mirror reflects the radiation towards prism and then to the rotating litho mirror. After falling on mirror, radiation reflected towards prism and then towards rotating litho mirror. What is the use of prism and rotating litho mirror? Both the prism and RLM is rotating litho mirror. Used to select the desired wavelength. And reflect back to the mirror. You can see here after falling on mirror, it reflects back to the mirror. From mirror, radiation falling onto the detector by passing through exit slit. From the mirror, radiation here transferred to the detector by passing through exit slit, falling onto the detector. In my next video, I will explain what are the detectors used. That means bolometer, thermocouple, bolacell, pyroelectric detector, various IR detectors are there. I will explain tomorrow by my next video. And what are the different radiation source, means nest glower, glower source, mercury arc and incandescent lamp. All these radiation sources will be explained tomorrow, instrumental components. Then from mirror, radiation fall onto the detector by passing through exit slit. Detector detects the intensity of radiation absorbed by the sample as a function of wavelength. This is the working principle. The disadvantages of single beam IR spectrophotometer is, intensity of radiation emitted by light source is not uniform. Whatever the radiation emitted by light source, that is not given by uniform. Uniform radiation is not obtained from the single beam IR spectrophotometer. Uniformity is not obtained. Then second one, when sample is analyzed in solution, The bands of solvents appear in spectrum. For suppose, if sample is analyzed in solution form, okay, the bands of solvent is appeared in spectrum. These two are the disadvantages of single beam IR spectrophotometer. Then coming to double beam IR spectrophotometer. Double beam. Okay, here this is the diagram of the double beam IR spectrophotometer. You can see the diagram. It is starting point is this one. Here light source. Okay. Here double beam means we know that two beams are visible, same as like double beam UV visible spectrophotometer. Here one beam is split into two beams. Okay, if two beams of equal intensity. Okay, you can see from radiation source. Light beam is split into two equal intensity beams. Okay, here one beam is split into two equal intensity beams. Same thing. Here beam is split into two beams of equal intensity. Here these two beams having equal intensity. Okay, one here both these two beams will fall onto the mirror one. M1 means mirror one. Okay, then after falling on these two beams, one is reflected back towards mirror two, one is reflected back towards mirror three. Okay, here you need to remember the nature of mirror is reflecting only. Okay, here whatever the radiation falling on mirror, okay, it is reflected back to the sample solution. Here whatever the radiation falling on mirror 3, it is reflected towards reference cell. The purpose of double beam IR spectrophotometer is at the same time we can analyze, okay, we can compare, we can analyze the sample and as well as reference at a time only, reference solution. Okay, Here, then from M2, okay, here radiation will fall onto the sample solution. From M3, mirror 3, the radiation falling onto the reference solution. Here, after falling on sample solution, okay, radiation falling on sample solution, here some amount of radiation absorbed. And remaining is transferred to the mirror 4 and mirror 5. Remaining is transferred to the mirror 4. Okay, here, after falling on some amount of radiation, here also reference solution some amount of radiation absorbed. Then remaining is transferred directly to the mirror 6. Here first it is falling onto the M4. The radiation falling on M4 will be reflected towards M5. Okay, M5. You see here M4, M5, here M6. Here the thing next it is next part of IR spectrophotometer, double beam IR spectrophotometer is rotating sector mirror. This is the important thing in the double beam IR spectrophotometer. The working of rotating sector mirror, you need to understand. The name itself indicating rotating. We can rotate it. Okay, we can rotate. It is possible. What is the importance? You can see here during half of its rotation, the rotating sector mirror reflects the sample beam and blacks the reference beam. Okay, here first we have to rotate the half of its rotation. Okay, this rotating sector has to rotate half only. We have to rotate half of its, okay, half of its complete rotation. Then to this half of rotation, what will happen? The radiation which is coming from sample will be reflected by the rotating mirror. The radiation which is coming from reference will be blacked by rotating sector mirror. For the first rotation, the rotating sector mirror reflect the sample beam, means reflect means it allows, okay, then blacks the reference beam. Okay, if blacking means during first half rotation, okay, here the rotating sector mirror blacking the reference beam, means it doesn't allow, okay, it blacks the reference beam, it only allows sample beam only. Here while other half of its rotation, the reference beam is allowed. This time after second half of its rotation, only reference beam is allowed, then after sample beam is blacked. This is the purpose of rotating sector mirror. So first what we need to do means, first we need to rotate half of its rotation. First half rotation, what it allows, only the radiation coming from sample will reflect towards M7. Okay, the radiation coming from reference, means which is coming reflected by M6, will be blacked by rotating sector mirror, means it doesn't allow. Okay, during first half rotation only allows sample beam only. The entire sample beam will fall onto the M7, then reflect it towards M8, then reflect towards M9. All these are M7, M8, M9 mirrors only. Then finally, here the after sample rotation will falling onto the M9 mirror 9. Okay, reflected by falling onto mirror 9. Here the radiation will reflect it towards mirror 10 by passing through entrance slit. Okay, here you need to observe. Here mirror 10. Okay, then the radiation which is falling on mirror 10, which is reflected towards prism and as well as lateral mirror. Okay, after falling on the mirror 10, the radiation reflected towards prism here, this one, and as well as rotating the lateral mirror. What is the purpose of this lateral mirror and prism? Same thing that we have discussed in the second beam IR spectrophotometer. By using this prism, by using a lateral mirror, both these, we can select desired wavelength only. We can use it for selecting the desired wavelength. Then after falling on this mirror and prism, both will reflect the radiation back towards mirror 10. Then from the mirror 10, the radiation reflect towards detector this time. Okay, by passing through E2 means exit slit. E1 is the entrance slit, E2 is the exit slit. Falling onto the detector detects the intensity of radiation absorbed by the sample in terms of wavelength. Okay, then this falling onto the radio device will give signals. Okay, in terms of wavelength was like that. Here first time what happened? Here sample beam only, here they are. First time the sample beam absorbed, here sample beam intensity is absorbed by the detector, absorption detected by the detector. Next, then after sample beam analyzed, next we have to rotate second half rotation. Then this time it allows here reference beam only. Means it, this time second half rotation it blacks sample cell. Then the beam the beam coming from reference is fall onto the M7, mirror 8, mirror 9, and same process M10. Then again falling onto the reflected back to the prism and lateral mirror. And both function then reflect again back to M10, then detector and readout device. So see here, what did you understand from this double beam IR spectrophotometer? Means the alternative, you can see here, the alternative sample and reference signal reaching the detector. Alternative, first we are allowing sample, then after reference signal reaching the detector, which is amplified and sent to the readout device. Okay, the readout device record the transmittance radiation as a function of its wavelength. Okay, this is the function of working principle of double beam IR spectrophotometer. You just remember the you just noted the arrow mark where it is going. Okay, arrow mark from here, then here. Okay, you can see arrow marks. You just observe the arrow mark, then you can understand clear pathway in double beam IR spectrophotometer. So this is the working principle of single beam and double beam IR spectrophotometer. Thank you. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and share it. Thank you very much.